The main entry and most important entry of the Latin American side of this continent. A city that has been known to be to have an amazing positive outcome of every struggle that it has faced. As we may know here, the last couple of years haven't been easy on this city. Which do any one of you or any of the presents have any information or any experience that they can share or something they know that happened in this city a couple of years ago? Back there.
I have lots of experience.
Lots of what? Sorry?
Yeah, there's a lot of experiences in this city.
Yes, but there was this thing that we've been recognized internationally. That we were worldwide known for this scenario. Besides from that.
Our crime level?
Crime level, right? We all know that crime level was at its highest about 4 or 5 years ago. Tijuana had this international image of a city that one of the most dangerous cities in the world, right? You heard Tijuana in the United States or any other place in the world, and the first thing that people associate with the city's name was insecurity. Don't go there. I know a couple of guys that studied in American University, and in the email database, they were all sent an email once that with an alert to specifically with the purpose, with the message of do not go to Tijuana because you're gonna get killed, basically. So that's what Tijuana was facing a couple of years ago. And that has changed. It has changed to this present moment. And I'm going to talk about one thing that has been very important in this change, in this image change, and how Tijuana's image is changing because of this. Next slide. My name is Jorge Armando Ramos, and I will be talking about the supporting the local food movement by buying and eating local food. I have one purpose today, which is convincing you of eating and consuming local food here. Next slide, please. First, I want to talk to you about Tijuana's gastronomic scene. The city of Tijuana offers a wide variety of local cuisine ranges, from world-class fine dining, casual eateries, and local-only spots, to street vendors serving up some of the best carne asada tacos in the world. The cuisine of Baja California is unlike anywhere else on the planet. Come and discover the incredible local ingredients and outstanding chefs and talents that the region has to offer. Accompany one of the dishes with a variety of locally crafted beers or a glass of Valle Guadalupe wine. It's very interesting how this gastronomic movement has been causing and has been one of the first causes of this positive image changing in Tijuana. And I'm going to specify this, and I'm going to narrow this in three specific reasons. Slide. We also have flavors from all around the world and concentrated in one city. It's my first reason. You can basically eat any type of food you want here in Tijuana. I mean, what's your favorite food? Someone?
Italian.
Italian. Have you been to Giuseppe's, Via Saverio's,
Vittorio's?
Who else?
Japanese
food, right? Sushi. Which sushi? Komasan, Daikishi. Exactly. And the best part about this is if we focus on one type of food, we don't only talk about one restaurant. There's plenty of restaurants that we can choose from. And I'm gonna talk about some of them. First of all, Caesar's, the home of the famous Caesar salad. A beautiful historic restaurant on the worldwide known Avenida Revolucion, with a price range of 80 pesos to 400 pesos, focused on international cuisine, Italian, contemporary Mexican, and Spanish. Here's some of the menu, with the entry soups, pastas, the main dishes, the salads, and the desserts. As you can see, besides from having high quality food, we also have a price range that isn't very high, which is really good for our economy. Next slide, please. Who has been to the Espadaña? What is España known for?
Chilaquiles,
right? Everybody has had the Spanish chilaquiles and chocomil, right? The best there is. And there's this beautiful colonial spot in the gastronomic district with a price range of 80 to 350 pesos, Mexican food. Here's the website and the menu. You can have everything from cornflakes, chilaquiles, enchiladas, all of the typical food. All of Mexican's typical food is in this place. Who likes coffee here? this new coffee place called Las Cortes, located in Hipódromo, next to the National Armory Hipódromo, with a price range of 20 pesos to 39 pesos. There's a website, and it offers high quality food, high quality coffee and time. Imported from the states of Chiapas and Veracruz and Oaxaca. Which takes me to this second reason. You have no idea how important it is that you consume local food to our city's economy, specifying in three special factors. First of all, Baja's gastronomic activity represents more than 20% of the state's GDP, percentage that is constantly growing year after year, representing more than 70,000 million pesos a year. As you can see, for one sector only, of all of the microeconomic factors that can make the 100% of an economy, a 20% is a very, very high percentage, and it's constantly growing. Reason number two, it is one of the top three reasons that generate employment in the region. And I'm not talking only about direct employment. What do I mean by this? When you put your own business, or when you put your a restaurant or a coffee shop or whatever you want, obviously you generate a manager, you generate the cooks, you generate maybe valet parking, and that's direct employment. And you also generate indirect employment. Here in Tijuana, you don't necessarily need to buy your rice or your milk or your syrups from Costco or any type of market. You can buy it from students that study gastronomy, which is a type of indirect employment. It's another way to incentive our economy here in the city. And the third reason is more than 34.6% of the family tourism expenses is caused by our city's restaurants, defining gastronomy as the number one attraction in the region, which will create indirect employment offers, just as I just mentioned. Third reason, which is how I started this presentation, be the change of your city's international image. We all know that big changes come from us. We have to be the change we want to see in the world, as we all hear from time to time. Tijuana has been internationally recognized by this gastronomic movement, with sources such as Sagat, with this review about six reasons Tijuana is hotter than ever, mentioning Tacos El Fan, Café de Volada, Café Starbucks, Café Las Cortes, mentioning La Espadaña, Misión 19, and this is very, very important because it is proved by facts and numbers how it has incentivized the tourism in the city. Another one is the Brilliant Gastronomic Adventure by the San Diego Red, talking specifically about Misión 19, which we all know is one of the finest restaurants in the city, and it can offer you high-quality food as if you were in any city in the world. Another example is the New Tijuana by UTS San Diego, which is the Union Tribune, which personally interviewed Miguel Ángel Guerrero, which is the owner of La Querencia. Have you been to La Querencia? Well, it's this amazing Baja Med restaurant in the gastronomic district. And this is very, very important because this type of reviews, this type of news wasn't something common a couple of years ago. People are starting to see Tijuana different, and you're being one of the main reasons of this. So I want you to be very conscious of the next time you go to eat, to also, besides from the enjoyment and the nice time you want to have, you can also be very proud of saying, hey, I'm helping Tijuana's economy. Hey, I'm helping to change how the world sees my city. I'm feeling proud of that. So, summing up, the three whys. You can eat any type of food known in the world in Tijuana. Number two, local gastronomy is the first and most important economic catalyzer in Tijuana. And number three, change the world the way the world sees our hometown. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope that this presentation has made you very conscious of all the impact you can have. I seriously invite you to visit our city, know your city, promote your city, bring friends from other countries. Be very proud of what is happening over here, because it is a reality. It is something that is changing the way our country and our city, and it's been seen. And as Charles Pierre Monsalet said, gastronomy has been the joy of all peoples through the ages. It produces beauty and wit, and it goes hand in hand with goodness of heart and consideration of others. I appreciate your time. Thank you.